Hey dear Trending Topics community, we just had a very awkward conference call. You're probably familiar with that type of communication, but not in a virtual reality environment, what we just had. A Bulgarian company named Quark VR just raised its second round of investments to continue developing that technology for enterprises. Let's check what they're doing. You are doing something different. You are doing software, it's not content. Can you explain a bit what is behind Quark VR?
We want to be the industry accelerator in a way. We want to bring VR to more people and we want to make the experience better, which means you don't have to be tethered to a computer to have a high-end experience. You don't have to buy into expensive hardware just to try VR. And with 5G, this is going to be much easier for us. Just having that, the connectivity and the bandwidth and the latency that this new technology gives us is going to help us put Quark and our streaming technology in the hands of a lot of people.
You just came back from Germany where you were testing 5G network with your technology. Why was that?
Right. Our trip to Germany was part of our partnership with Deutsche Telekom, who is going to be the major 5G provider for Germany. And edge cloud and 5G networks are going to be a big leap in telecommunications, but also they're going to be very important for technologies like AR, VR, autonomous vehicles, etc. We are working on a project with Deutsche Telekom that is for Volkswagen, the automotive company. And the goal of the project is to deliver factory training to a Volkswagen facility. We're starting small with a sandbox test, but once we prove that that technology works, that you can use our streaming over a 5G network, even though the actual content is being rendered somewhere else, then we can scale it pretty fast. And with Orange, we're doing something similar where we're testing our technology over their 5G network as well. And they have some very interesting ideas for both for enterprise and for consumers.
How does a Bulgarian startup manage to attract investors like HTC and partners like Orange, Deutsche Telekom and Intel?
Well, we did have a lot of help, that's for sure. The startup ecosystem and the VC ecosystem here in Sofia has grown drastically since we started the company in 2014. It's been 4 years. We've had local investors like Wouchkup and Angels, and we got introduced to the Launch Hub portfolio. We got introduced to Orange, and we got introduced to Boost VC, which is a San Mateo-based accelerator.
What are you going to do with that money?
So that money is going to be invested in our projects with Orange DT and some other very cool project that we have in the pipeline. We would like to scale our small team. We're not gonna drastically increase the number of people working at Quark. We don't have to at this point. But we've come to a point where we have a very exciting project on our hands, a lot of work to do, not enough people. So we're actively looking for engineers right now.
Still, you raised your latest round in Bulgaria. Why?
Right. I think, so as a general rule in fundraising, money doesn't move much, which means that the closer you are to your investors, the easier it is to close the deal. If you have good business and a great product, you could easily raise like a legitimate Series A round without leaving Sofia.
Which are, from your point of view, the major trends that are going to shape the VR market in the near future?
I think that the standalone headsets are going to be great. First, we're gonna see more game studios committing. I think in the enterprise, we already have companies that have been working on this for years. They're gonna keep growing. We're gonna see the first few unicorns, I hope, soon. But once especially the gaming side picks up, then other people are going to start paying attention. The user growth actually, not too many people pay attention to this, but it's still not as huge as we would hoped, or some people would have hoped, but the number of VR users doubled over the last year. So it is growing. If it keeps up the exponential growth, it's gonna be fine. In a couple of years, it's gonna be amazing.
And how does the near future look for Quark VR?
We have the potential to grow that very, very fast. And especially working with enterprises, one contract can turn you profitable, especially for a small team like ours. So I'm hopeful that we're gonna turn to profitability in the next 18 months for sure.